How's it going, film and TV fans? Welcome back to another review on the Off The Cuff Film Reviews. And it is officially spooky season. Well, it has been for 4 days now. So this month is going to primarily be reviews of spooky Halloween-esque movies. And obviously, as such, as you've previously seen, if you've watched my Looking Back at No Time To Die video, you'll know that the outro music has changed to the spooky variant because it's spooky-ween. So yeah, obviously, I've covered Halloween movies in the past. There will be a Halloween special that will drop on Halloween, and that will most likely be Halloween Ends, so that will be fun. But I thought I would start Spooky Month with a classic, one of the most important horror movies ever made that changed the genre for better, mostly for better, but a little bit for the worse, as it would be the primary focus of the genre for the next few years to come, until it would be changed once again by another form of horror. But it would be a franchise that would stick around to continue to make fun of said changes over the last few years, but hasn't been as active as other franchises, and that is, of course, Scream, a series that currently has 5 movies, with a 6th movie set to release next year. The first 4 movies were directed by by Wes Craven, known for, you know, the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise, directing the first Nightmare on Elm Street movie, and Wes Craven's New Nightmare. I don't know if you could tell who directed that movie, but the original Scream came out in 1996, its sequel came out in 1997, and the third one came out in 2000, although that one was a little bit more messy when it comes to its production. But here, this original Scream was written by Kevin Williamson. It also housed the landmark of being the very first movie scored by legendary composer Marco Beltrami. So, you know, that is a feat upon itself, because, you know, his score for these movies, well, it may not be as an iconic horror score as, say, you know, Halloween, but it's still pretty good. And Scream itself is one of the best horror movies, I have to admit. It's an absolutely fantastic movie because it manages to be so meta and make fun of the genre in so many different ways. It's really fantastic. That's what I love the most about it. It's a horror, but it's also a comedy as well at the same time. And it's also a very meta movie. It was the first of that kind of almost subgenre of the horror genre being meta and being, you know, self-aware is the big word thrown around for this movie, because it is a very self-aware movie, and that's what I love the most about it. I think it's self-aware, and while if you were to watch it nowadays, it would seem very cliche to be self-aware, but back when it came out, which you've got to keep into context when you talk about movies like this, it was groundbreaking, because no other movie had openly and so you know, had openly mocked the horror genre as much as this movie had, which is fantastic, because again, it marked the complete change of the genre. You know, right from the very opening scene, it started the whole idea of being cliched, not being cliched, but, you know, being self-aware by referencing movies like Halloween and Friday the 13th and Nightmare on Elm Street in that first sequence with Casey Becker, and that is one of the better sequences in the film. It's fantastic. Now, horror movies are a nice genre, because they do have a lot of other videos you can do research with, primarily from the channels Dead Meat and Caesar's World, are the channels I watch the most, or the channels I watch the most, and I love watching their videos about it. Obviously, with Dead Meat, it's the kill counts, but with Caesar's World, it's more things you miss and stuff like that, so that's really helpful when reviewing and dissecting movies, especially things you missed as well. So, yeah, there's a lot of really well-placed things in this movie, and like I said, Beltrami's musical score is just as good as well.
Thank you.
But yeah, I'd say it's such one of the more perfect horror movies. It's one I'd recommend you everyone give a watch because it is fantastic. It's one of the best horror movies because it's so meta, like I said, and it has a great cast as well. You've obviously got Drew Barrymore in a basically glorified cameo, but you've got Neve Campbell, you've got Matthew Lillard, who is just the best in this movie. He's my favourite part about this movie. You got Skeet Ulrich, you got David Arquette, and the Friends lady, whose name Courtney Cox, as well. So it's got a very, very good cast. Stu Marker, particularly, is my favourite character in the movie because he's so. And Matthew Lillard's performance is probably the best performance in this movie as well. But it's important to note that Scream's continual meta-ness and self-awareness continues across the entire franchise, all the way into, you know, literally across every single movie. And I'm sure I'll be covering all 5 Scream movies on this channel during the course of the month. And yeah, but Scream is one of the most just important horror movies. I have it on 4K Ultra HD because I watched it for the first time on a not strictly legal place, but I bought the 4K because I loved it so much. I think it's one of the best. Like I said, I remember very vividly when they're announcing Scream 5 and stuff like that, and I didn't basically know Scream franchise was, so I thought it was like a Final Destination or something like that. Like, it was a franchise that's always getting his new movie, kind of cool thing. But and I was never had the intention of seeing Scream 5 when it came out. But you know, I in the months leading up to Scream 5's release, now known as simply Scream, because they're doing that half funny thing where Reboot just called themselves the name of the franchise, like Halloween and Halloween and stuff like that, like Halloween, the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, you know. Black Christmas did it, all sorts did it, Candyman did it, you know, that kind of cliche thing. I rate them for doing it, it makes sense, and it works. But, yeah, no, I watched all the Scream movies leading up to it on, well, Scream's 1 through 3 on a not-so-legal place, and Scream 4 was streaming on Netflix in the United Kingdom, which I believe it still is at this point, so that's helpful. And I own Scream 2022 on Blu-ray, on 4K, and Scream 2 is getting its 4K treatment, and I pre-ordered that shit, so yeah. But yeah, Scream is a very important horror movie. It's one of the best. It's one that I am very upset that I didn't manage to watch sooner. Yeah, it's just so entertaining. It's so funny, and there's so many meta moments. One of my favourite meta moments is there's a moment where Jamie Kennedy's character Randy is sat on a sofa watching Halloween, and he goes, "Look behind you, Jamie," like 4 or 5 times, and behind him is Ghostface, and obviously the actor's called Jamie, so it's that kind of meta-ness that really puts this movie apart from anything that came before or after it. Obviously, Scary Movie heavily inspired by this and that. What can I say? It's a fantastic little movie, and I hope everyone gets a chance to watch it, because it's brilliant. Yeah. Thanks so much for watching my review of Scream. I hope you are going to enjoy my coverage of lots of scary movies, and yes, that will include the rest of the Halloween franchise. I'll be getting around to that. But it's also stuff like the Final Destination franchise that I want to talk about in this month as well. So stay tuned for that. And also other horror stuff like Jordan Peele's Us. Possibly. Nope. If it you can get copies of it, you know. Different horrors that I want to talk about. Yeah. Thanks so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. And bye-bye for now.